What's up? Welcome to the video series about making a game called Songbringer. Today I'm working on the hidden boss. This is a spoiler alert stream. If you don't want the secret spoiled, don't watch this stream. Until you've had your chance to play this and experience this secret. I'm working on a hidden boss. And it's also finally using this sphere thing. I've like always wondered, what's this sphere gonna be? What the heck is this? So finally, this is used. So I'm about to reveal the secret here. What basically you need to use your meditation skill and then super bombs. Kilobombs. And that combo will unlock this secret. So. I just used it in the wrong order. Whoops. Okay, so yeah, you gotta meditate first. And then you can use super bombs. Oh, she stole my last super bomb. Oh, I need super bombs. Damn, I don't got jib. Okay, well, we gotta do that again then. Give me some more super bombs, man. Why are you holding out on me? There. Now if she steals one, we still got two left. Man, this is so, last night I was working on this and I got really excited because, this thief boss, this is the, well, obviously this is the thief right here. She steals stuff from you. This is her as a boss. I keep doing that. Oh, not a cactus. All right. I could have just saved the last one. So anyways, you do that to crack this sphere open, and you can even save the game this way and the sphere will still be open. In fact, let me just do that. Confirm that. Yeah. And then, hey, with the super bomb. Okay, so here's where I need to start doing some art. So we need some art for her. But this is the cool part. Fighting her like this is so freaking fun. Just all you see is an invisible footsteps. All you see is like, is that. Except when she does her melee attack. So she's gonna have this melee attack. So when she gets close, it's like a freaking game of cat and mouse. You're chasing her or she's chasing you. You don't know what's going on. You're entirely by feel instead of sight. And it's like no other boss fight in the game, so it's like super exciting to be working on. So besides, she's the hidden boss, she's the thief. It's so cool that she's mostly invisible for the fight, except when she does her melee. So that's what I want. When she hits you with the melee attack, is it on invisible? So there we go. When she hits you with the melee, she needs to have some kind of animation where she becomes somewhat visible. So you kind of have, you know, so she, it for some points, and also when you hit her. So when you hit her, she becomes, it like glitches her invisibility item for a second. So that's going to be fun to animate. So lots of animations to do today. But also, I also want to do like a thing where she throws bombs and she's getting stuck. That's right. I don't know what the hell's going on right there. She just is stuck. Okay, so, but the first part, to make this clear, is to remove all the blood from the ground. The blood is really, really confusing when all you have to go on is her footsteps, and there's just these little black pixels on the ground. And then there's tons of blood on the ground, too. That just does not work. And same thing with the burn marks from lightning. So the first thing I'm going to do is remove those and see if it clarifies this boss fight and makes this a little bit more interesting and less cluttered. Okay, so the blood function, if it's, nah, we'll go to where it actually calls blood. That's where we have the entity, all the entities stuff. Blood and shake for foes. I think this is it. So the last, this one is when the boss is exploding, right? On this is on foe death. Right, so when she dies, we definitely want to see some blood. But just when she's normally hit. Do we have the area? Oh, yeah, we do. Sweet. Okay. And area dot pattern is not equal to K pattern sphere one. Cool. Let's see if that works. So, and also burn marks. Burn mark. Oh, where does it do those burn marks? AI system? Is it here? You know what? I kind of want this to be universal. So this burn mark, yeah, this will be a little bit more easy to manage if I just make it so all burn. Oh, I'm already getting the area anyway. Yeah. If area.pattern equals K pattern sphere one, never any burn marks. Cool. Let's see how that feels with hopefully less clutter. You focus on her footsteps. And besides, her footsteps kind of fade out, so those won't even clutter themselves, or they shouldn't. So you get a really cool item from beating her, and I'm thinking she's gonna be really difficult. So you're gonna have to hold off. If you happen to get the killer bombs really early, which is a really fun way to play Songbringer, you lose, you know, once again, spoiler alert, you lose Jib. So basically, that changes the whole game. But it's really interesting because now you can get Vel, and you have the killer bombs, which are really cool because there's some super secrets that require the killer bombs. So anyways, you can get the killer bombs early if you find them. There's two places you can get them. You get them Lord Songbringer, and then there's one secret on the overworld where there's always some overworld location where there is killer bombs, where you have to like burn a bush, explode a block or something like that, and it goes to some other secret area, secret cave, and that's where the killer bombs are. And I'm thinking those will even be protected by gate items, perhaps. So it's a little bit more involved to get. You'd have to get at least like one item before you got the kill bombs. But anyways, wow, cool. That graphic looks really neat at this time of night. Wow. That's like a GIF right there. Let's make a GIF of that. Just making a GIF real quick. So, about GIFs. If y'all want to make your own game and stuff like that, it's really nice to have any kind of thing hooked up into your game so you can quickly make a GIF. So anyways, I've got something like that. Thief comes too. What's up, Loki Kappa? How you been, man? Yeah, it's been a minute. What you been up to? Right, so let's turn that into a GIF. So basically what that does when I turn on that little flag there is it starts recording pings of the screen. Eves, what's up? Howdy. Howdy. I'm good. I'm good. I'm really good, actually. So what I'm spoiling here, actually, I kind of already spoiled it. So from now on, well, yeah, I don't really have to say much more about it. No, actually, for the next, I don't know, I kind of am. I'm kind of spoiling this hidden boss. It's a hidden boss. So if you want to know the secret to getting this hidden boss, then watch this stream. But if you want it to stay a secret, you probably shouldn't watch this stream. But anyways, it'll mostly be working on this boss. I won't really reveal. I'll try not to reveal too much. So it just records a bunch of pings. How are you doing, Eves, by the way? How is everything? How is everyone? So yeah, some pings. You delete the ones you don't want, and then I got a little script that makes a GIF of them using image magic. Yeah, image magic. It's just called GIF. It's a great little script. So it just combines all those pings into a GIF, and then I throw it in. I don't know if I've ever done this on a stream, so this is I'm showing how I make a GIFs. So I throw it in here, and then I select, you know, something interesting. Boogs! Whoa! What's up, Boogie? Hey, man, it's been a minute. How you doing? What's going on? And then you always got to render GIFs at least 200% when you're doing pixel art. So that. See, this one we can do more. So that Twitter doesn't mess your GIF up. I meant to type sphere right there, but I'm just gonna keep it sheer. It's kind of like sphere. Cool. Look at this. I'm actually posting a GIF on the stream. I'm like doing marketing right now. Check it out. Watch me market stuff. Oh, probably said. Oh, yeah. I'm working on a hidden boss today. Hidden boss, man. So this is a spoiler alert. I'm kind of going to reveal the secret to. I'll probably accidentally reveal the secret during the next 15 minutes. While I'm working on it. But I will be working on a cool boss today. And she's the hidden boss. Super sweet. How you doing, Boogie? So it was probably buffering, but how are you doing, man? You're ready to intercept the secrets. Does that loop right? I think I accidentally got it to loop right on the first try. That's amazing. This is so amazing. Look at that. So there you go. 10 minutes of marketing. Bam. So easy. You're doing good? Right on, man. What's new, dude? You've been flying some drones and stuff? Yeah, no worries, no worries. We've all just been here talking about you the whole time, you know? Wonder what Boogie's doing. What's he been up to? I'm joking, I'm joking. All right, cool. So we made a GIF. That was kind of cool. So here, I'm gonna just go keep on working on the rest. I gotta get everything in a state where it's like a little bit easier to work on this boss. Because right now you got to do these like things, like you got there's two actions you have to perform to get this hidden boss to reveal herself. Yeah, oh, you haven't been up to much. Did somebody reply already? Probably. Is their name Eves? I gotta get that thing where it does your notifications on Mac and you can just reply to tweets right there. It's like I turned it off a while ago, but I kind of need to turn it back on. It's kind of neat. All right, anyways, I gotta turn that off. We're done with this folder. No need this old thing. And here, we got a GIF to store in the cool GIFs folder. All right, so to keep on playing, we should be starting with half of the requirements for launching this boss, this hidden boss. So here's the second half of the requirement. That's actually the thief right there. She just stole something from me. Okay, here. So this is where I need to start working on the pixel art. She looks like really too simple at this point. And then, but anyways, before that, I want to save the game right now. And I want to make it easier to start this boss fight because I don't want to launch a bomb every single time. So I'm going to do something kind of like basically, if we set the thief to 2, then for now we'll go to, oh yeah, where it creates the sphere tile. And if the quantity of thief item, oops. All right, so if quantity thief is 2, which is supposed to indicate that the thief boss fight is over. And oh, I guess we need to get the hero. So, and the hero also has. Oh, wait, we already did this. Yeah, so if you don't have the thief, but you do have quantity thief. Ah, so that's how it's gonna be. All right, so this is just basically something that's gonna launch this boss fight quicker, but it'll also be something that kind of falls back. If for some reason the player has a messed up item state, it should correct itself automatically here. So if they don't have the name Thief, then it's basically trying to say you already did this fight. So here's where we want to add the name. Thief boss. So it just automatically creates her. Let's see if that works. Oops. Well, this is needs just a one. There we go. Okay, so hopefully that launches this boss fight faster. I should probably set a breakpoint if this doesn't work, though. Hopefully it works on the first try. Quantity, if you don't have thief, and the quantity's two. Oh, that means we also need for there to not be a thief. No. Ah, where is it? It's flask empty too. There's some check. There it is. If we have the name thief, yeah, this is before it creates the sphere tile. It clears the name thief if you have the full flask. Okay, right. So if by the time it creates the sphere tile, I switched to Vim a while ago, couple months ago, yeah. I mostly develop in Vim now, and then I just open Xcode when I need to debug, because Vim's a lot faster. What's up, Diamond Killer? Especially faster with autocomplete and all those like nice features of modern editors. Okay. So it's if we have the thief. Never mind. So it needs to look like this. If the quantity thief. Is two, and we don't have the flask quest or the flask two yet, then we'll get into this bit, and that's where we add the name thief boss. Oh, and remove the name thief. Well, no, doesn't really matter. Yeah, we need to remove the thief. Yeah, Vim. Yeah. I started making the switch to Vim a couple months ago, and wasn't it a couple months ago? I kind of started the whole process a whole year ago when I switched my game keys to Vim keys, so I kind of got used to the motion. But yeah, basically like 3 months ago, I really made the switch, and I've haven't looked back ever since. I finally got like the normal things you need, like autocomplete and all of the things like that working. Gosh, it's just been so much faster to develop. You know, everything is faster. Running the game is faster. Compiling the game is faster. Writing code, editing code, finding code, all that kind of stuff. Oh, and we needed not to create the sphere. And all this needs to happen before, or we just go like this. Regular. Okay, so this is no sphere, add thief boss. She's still not starting in the middle. Create AI. All right, so put her there in the middle of the screen. Yeah, the sidebar thing, right? You like that? Cool. I try not to make it too big. I don't want it to be like, you know, just like dominating the screen, but you know, it's nice to have, hopefully it's nice to have that little information there. So if you're just browsing the stream or you're stumbling across this stream, you know kind of what's going on. Cool. Did it even do the boss intro sound? Nice. Okay. See how this feels with a little bit more. She's stuck already. Yes. It's so cool. So now there's no blood on the ground and there's no burn marks either. So there's nothing black on the ground at all, except for her footprints, which makes this boss fight so awesome. All right, yay, now it's time to do the pixel art. Okay, so there's a couple animations I'm gonna do for her. One of them is a running east-west animation, so that when she gets, whenever you hurt her, like this, where's her hurt animation? I drew the hurt animation already. Oh, the publisher, man, it's great. Yeah, it's really, really great. And let me give you some perspective on that too. I've had a publisher before in my life, publishing games when I was in my teens. My very first games I wrote in when I was like 15, 16, 17, 18, a couple of them got published and it wasn't a very good deal. Basically I kind of, you know, it just wasn't that great. So basically today, to have a publisher that's super cool about everything, that like lets me do whatever the heck I want, you know, as far as creatively, I'm just doing whatever I want here with this game, you know, and they're just fully backing me no matter what. They're like, make this awesome, you know, it's really, really great to have that. And also to be putting the game on Xbox and PlayStation, as well as Steam, all at the same time, is a huge thing in games. Like, it really, really helps your release go well when you've got all your platforms at once, because people that are reviewing it, you know, writing articles about it, and things like that, they can play it on whatever platform they want to. You know, if you're the kind of person that loves playing on Xbox, and, you know, wouldn't you prefer to play on Xbox? The same thing with Steam or PlayStation or whatever. And whatever other platforms we end up putting it on. But for sure, we're going to launch those platforms all at once. And that's a really, really rad thing. And then another thing that's really rad about having a publisher is they're able to get Songbringer represented at events, at these expos, which is huge. Like being at GDC, I got to do like a whole bunch of indie events there. Like I was at, what was it called? Oh, The Mix. Yeah. I guess still got my little poster from it. I was a showcase developer there. That was really sweet. So Songbringer got showcased, which was really, really great. And then I got to like meet with like lots of people doing tons of press, like interviews and things like that all during GDC week. And also for the first time, I got to explore the GDC Expo, which is really neat. Like it's so incredibly valuable to see how other game companies are representing their games at these expos and play the cool games that are coming out and see what like and be more active in the game development scene, you know? Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Yep. And then another great thing was being at PAX. So we went, so they, we were at PAX. They had Songbringer at a booth and everything with the Indie Mega booth. So we were part of the Indie Mega booth. It was cool. So we were in Boston at PAX East doing the Indie Mega booth, and Songbringer was represented there. And people were at one point on Saturday. Saturday was a super busy day to be at PAX. And then that's not even like Friday and Sunday, and were also really, really busy days. We're talking like 25 to 35,000 people in the event per day. So Saturday was just packed. Like, I mean, it was probably just up to the gills, like 35,000 people all in this like arena expo center place. And just so much, like I took a little video of it. There's just so much going on. So a sea of people and like all these different games and booths and things like that. So many lights and sounds. It's crazy. Yes, they organized, paid for it. So that's like, I can't afford that. Yeah, I cannot afford to put my game at a booth on my own. You know what I mean? That's really cool. And to have them like be cool people as well. It's like, what? This is a dream cool situation. So I'm really, really, I really like Double 11. They've been good to me. And I'd like to be good to them too. Yes, tons of great feedback from being there. As usual, anytime, I get to see somebody play Songbringer in person, it really, really, every time I'm like, oh, I can think of little things to improve in the game. And so, I got like lots of things added to my Trello list to do, to make the game better. But also like just actual like general feedback from players was lots of excitement. There's lots of people really excited about Songbringer and really in like kind of in love with that same co that concept of bringing back that sort of the feelings that the first Zelda, evoked, and some of the first like action RPGs like Mystic Quest and other like action RPGs of that day, like they're really exploring that whole concept. And I think the very first Zelda really nailed it with just how to like let the player explore. And in fact, I'm even frustrated with the new Zelda. I don't know why people are so, well, I know why people are so excited about the new Zelda. I like it too. I'm not knocking it. I'm not saying the new Zelda is a bad game at all. It's a rad game. It's probably the best Zelda lately by far. But still, they start you off in a room with only one choice, and then they throw you in a tutorial area. It's like, I'm so sick of that. So sick of those kind of games. And to watch people react to the game and everything. Yeah. Oh, sorry. Yeah. I had to share that though, man. I had to share that with you and anyone else that hasn't heard this amazing story of what's been going on lately. It's an amazing story. Sit down in your chair, get a cigar, have a glass of cognac or something. Okay, so anyways, let's start animating. First of all, let's get a good look for her first, her idol. We don't need a sphere cracked or the sphere for a while. We got this visible. This is it, the visible one. Start drawing this. Nice, man, nice. Put this at 30. Like, it's nice to have a little bit of a darker background that represents the game a little bit better, more accurately when you add lighting. So brightness of about 34 has really been helping me lately with drawing characters. So she's kind of like a ninja. Thinking like a red. Oh yeah, red and green. Red and green. Oh yeah, I saw this really red and green and black, lots of black too. So let's get like a reddish Make a palette. Oh, and her hurt animation wasn't even playing. Why was that? Thief boss. Hurt, yeah. Yeah, so first animation there. Boom, 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 boom. Wonder why that didn't work. Oh well, can't wonder about it too long. I'd rather do pixel art right now. Okay, so I'm liking her about the same height as the player, but I'm thinking when she does like some of her animations, she'll actually get bigger. It'll look cool, but maybe not too big. So let's get a nice. Let's make a yeah, a palette of greens, reds. Oops. Oh, right. Yeah, I know. It really is. That's why I feel so lucky about finding Double 11. Them finding me, really. They found me during the Kickstarter. So, yeah. And to even have okay, like to even have a publisher decide that your game is something that they would like to publish is a really, you know, it's a really like big compliment as a developer. I feel really cool about it all. But just to find one that's such a good match, you know? It's cool. I feel like I'm some rock artist or something like that that found the ultimate label, you know? Like a label that's actually really cool. So I'm just mixing up some palette colors. It's crazy what hue and saturation can do on their own. It looks like a good start there. Let's get this going. Oh, also, let's get a really red color. Maybe even pure red. Yeah. Okay, so she's gonna have this like sash thing. This green's not dark enough. That's kind of cool. Making her skin look actually like. She could be wearing like, yeah. Ah, cool. Yeah, let's do a maybe 50% blend of these. Get more of a red color for her hat sash thing, and then like a deeper red color. Do I ever wish the picture in the Navigator was actual size? This thing? Nah, I kind of like it the way it is. Oops. Yips. Right, this thing, yeah. I kind of like it the way it's. I like it small because I'll do this a lot when I make art. It's like I squint sometimes or something like that. You can like or like sort of like unfocus your eyes to kind of look at the more like just almost step back in a way and look at the bigger picture. So that's why I really like the Navigator being small. It's just like you don't even have to squint at it. You can kind of I like to eye it all the time and look at the Navigator sometimes, even when I'm drawing. Like I'll like. Just look at the Navigator instead of this. So what if her skin kind of looks like this? She's got almost this like snake skin. One one? No, this is one one. This, you mean like this? Put it at 100%. It's, yeah, 100% is really tiny, man. That's 100%. This is like 2500% or something like that, because it's pixel art. This is, yeah, 2000%. Comfortable 2000%. Yeah, it just fits into space, whatever that is. So if you like it, you make it bigger or smaller or whatever. It's just, see? I like to have it just about, you know, as big as I can get it, usually, and whatever width it is. Oh, so it's not 1:1? Oh, I don't know. I don't know what it is. Okay, so this is going to require. Some in-game testing. Let's see if we can get some highlights on her, though. Make it really pop. Actually, that's oh, it looks a little too bright. Let's try that at 50. Oops. I think her clothes might be a little too not, they're not black enough. All right, so select these red clothes. Go with something a little redder. And darker. Okay, it'd be interesting to note what it would be like if these pixels were not affected. Let's see it in the game. I don't know what this is gonna be like until it's got 2 frames. What's up, Strafe Green? Huh. She kind of looks like too much like a pirate. And the hair is so bright. I don't know why it's so bright. This is C++. So I'm gonna try and tone down the red brightness here. Everything about this is like this. Nah, yeah, okay. Let's keep the darker bit there. Thank you, man. Appreciate the compliment. Okay, so it's like she's almost like a little too circusy with these, like the skin. I'm trying to go for like a snake skin look, but this just looks too circusy and with the game's lighting. So I'm gonna start blending this lighter. Yeah, it's already on Steam. Well, not really. For sale, it's not on sale on Steam yet, but yeah. There's a link to it here on songbringer.com. There's a link to the Steam page. So basically, it's not for sale on Steam yet. It's coming out this summer. And it's coming out on Steam, Xbox, and PlayStation. And another thing about this, this red color was like too bright, like way too bright. So I need to tone that down a lot. In fact, almost all the way to this red color. Okay, let's hope she doesn't look too piratey anymore. Figured it out. It's also that her sash, or yeah, her head sash thing needs to not be on wrapped around her head, because that's what's giving the pirate impression. So she needs like a face mask too to be more ninja-like. Yeah, that's better. And probably less of her arms exposed. And she probably is wearing gloves of some sort. Let's just keep this more simple too. Yeah, okay, and so she's not gonna have those highlights. These highlights need to be like, Yeah, it's starting to get better. I think she could be taller now. Let's make her like an Amazon. I was like, that might be one pixel too many. That's pretty good. All right, cool. Yeah, right. See you, Eves. That's better. Sometimes one pixel can make all the difference. Right, see that? Yeah, white wraps are not this character's colors. Yeah, this character is meant to be more like a darker ninja. She's really stealthy. So the whole point of this boss fight is just she turns invisible. So this is just her look at first, and then she turns on her invisibility item and you can't see her. So this is just like to give her some context of what she actually is supposed to look like. What the hell is with this? Why isn't she playing her hurt animation? It's kind of a cool animation. It's probably one of the coolest. Pretty cool. Yeah, okay, let's start doing the attack animation too. That's a pretty good start, I think, to her look. I like it. Well, maybe darker? I don't know. Make her neon green. I don't know. Let me see if I might make her a little darker before I. Or maybe she's partially transparent. Oh, and her shadow offset was a little too high. Offset 5 is like way too much. In fact, is the thief like that? Oh shit, this is way too much shadow offset for a tinier character. That's a good fix. So yeah, she has no render component, or I mean reflection component. I kind of want to do something where she has an invisible extra layer that does the shadows. But that'll be something for later. So basically, she'll be invisible, but she still has a shadow. That'll be really cool to see. Right now, the way the system works, if the character oh man, I just thought maybe I could change her opacity actually live. Huh, that might be fun too. Okay, so she needs now she needs an melee animation. Let's get this and make it really cool. So that's a good start to her look. I can't worry too much about a character at first, because I know by tonight I'll have some more ideas, and I'll be like, oh, she should look a little more like this, or this will be so sick if her animation did that. So I can't worry about too much. I just gotta like move on and start another animation because we gotta get this boss fight really humming and feeling better. I'd like for her to have this, you know, her melee animation done, and for her to be able to throw bombs or possibly knives. Male 24 palette? What's that? Okay, let's get a frame where she is at like the height of her movement or something. This is visible. I need that one open again. Visible does not need that, whatever that is. Oh, she needs some kind of animation to this little bit, of course. Her shoulders can move at least. Nice. Oh, that's beautiful. That's got a really nice look to it. Wow. It's really bright and fun. Okay, so to animate her into the, I want to get to the like the most extreme extent of her animation first. First of all, she's gonna jump. She's gonna be forward a little bit. She's gonna have a slash coming through here. Let's do a pure white slash of energy. Cool, yeah, it's got that really happy look. All very like pleasing colors. I like it. It's good balance too. It's got some nice browns. I'm comparing it to like 16 colors. I'm thinking of like the last 16 color palette I looked at was CGA. Yeah, Salad and I were looking at that the other day. CGA palette. Okay, so this arm is gonna come all the way around. Means her back is going to be to the player right here. The sash is going to go crazy wild. So she can have her other arm out, kind of like extended. Her leg. So, where does this sash actually attach? I'm trying to think. It's kind of like comes up. So, can make it like a little longer than it actually is, I think, in this animation. Because this animation will go by so fast. You won't even notice. Just getting out the rough shapes first before doing anything else. Let's work backwards now. Oops. So this one actually is better to work this way. Like halfway between these two frames. This little sash part where her sash animates can't really happen until she does a little more movement, but I think she can get a little bit of movement out of it. Okay, let's get rid of this frame. She starts there in this animation, and We need like one more frame. Maybe she actually flips her sword over this way and goes backwards. That'd be kind of cool to see. So her arm would go like this, basically. Oops. Okay, I need to more quickly see if this animation is working before I invest any more into it. That's hilarious. So she needs to have a little bit more transparency through this. So like here, she's maybe only 40% transparent. But maybe her blade is fully opaque the whole time. Here she's like maybe 70%. There she's fully. Here we can at least do. Anyways, all right, something like this. It's good to make art rough at first, you know, just like rough shapes, rough like pixel art, just everything that's really not caring about the perfection of it, just to see how things animate first and the overall colors feel and the proportions of characters and stuff. And then later on, once you're like happy with how things are, then you can go back and make things look really good. So her attack is going too slow. She needs an animation for she can cloak and decloak as well. Gonna need like at least two melee animations. Am I just not starting with much health or what? I'm in full health? Damn, she rips you a new one fast. Animation too. Damn. Die so fast. Okay, maybe she shouldn't do that much damage. What's up, MNT? Mount Zero? Is that what that is? Attack damage. Let's take this down to 0.5. It's killing me too fast. Oh, it's Clock. What's up, Clock? Okay, I'm really disappointed because she's not playing this animation. I really want to see this. This hurt. I think this needs to be a lot more. Oh, there it is. Oh, so it's just going by too fast. Maybe she can't be hit with lightning. No. Okay, she's stuck. Oh, she keeps getting stuck. Why do you get stuck sometimes? There we go. Seeing that hurt animation really helps. Fighting a completely invisible enemy is so sweet. Yeah, she really cannot do much more than a half tooth worth of damage because it is really hard to fight an invisible enemy. She can't have those spawn. Okay, sweet. The next thing I want to do is to give her to work on her gameplay a little bit more. I want to try her having these bombs she can throw. So, clock set to mountain time. Okay, so this fight's coming along a little bit. Oh, but there's some stuff I don't want to check in yet. All right. I'm not going to worry about this yet. Okay, I want to create something where she can throw bombs now. Which means it'll be kind of like a projectile, but then it explodes. So I guess we could create a bomb or a bomb foe, and then the bomb foe just gets a launched. You could either get launched in the air, or it could, yeah, actually you just get launched in the air. So when it initially gets created, it could set a vector for itself. That ought to work. And then when it hits the ground, it explodes. Yeah. Okay, cool. So the thief boss, let's like make her when she has this mode. Let's put it after her melee. If mode 0. If target any, if target is far away, like maybe 80, 60, 80, yeah, maybe 80, 80 pixels or so away, then we're going to. Launch a bomb toss, bomb foe thrown. Okay, I'm gonna give it a lifetime of 2 seconds. I think that should be enough. And then we see a delay. Probably need some randomness on here too. Zero point five to 1.0 maybe. And then she can throw more bombs if she wants. Okay, so let's get those bomb thrones started. Data weapons, bomb foe, throne. Okay, so we got bomb foe thrones now. All right, when these things get launched or created, they have a behavior. They have explode. They're also going to have flags, vector movement. I think that's how you do vector movement. Yeah, flags vector movement. Okay. Okay, so similar to like a poison bubble launches itself. Oh, wow. A poison bubble just. All it has to do is manage its own lifetime, I think. So all it has to do is give itself Z velocity when it gets launched. Start with the poison bubbles behavior because it's pretty good starting point. But remove category, remove timer, remove. I would need an initial. If timer begin, then I think it's velocity C. I don't know how this works exactly. I forget. Is there a velocity command? I forgot. Oh yeah, you can do velocity. Oh right, X, Y. Okay. So this needs to be 0, 0, like 200. Let's see how the AI system is going to handle that. Oh, it needs to have a move component. That's right. Bomb foe thrown. Move. Move mask. Static. Actually, this is just default, I think. All right, let's see if she can throw these. Throwing bombs. Maybe some knives. Whoa. It's calm. constantly exploding bombs up here. They're instantly exploding. I'm not sure if any of these sequences are actually correct. Frisbees? You want frisbees? Yeah, it's C++. And I'm using Cocos 2DX. Okay, so now all they have is a velocity 0, 0, 200. Where she just keeps on throwing bombs. Huh. I gotta get a better way to throw bombs. These aren't being thrown yet. It's not launching them with velocity or anything yet. Oh, it needs a move speed, that's for sure. Speed, like, you should be pretty fast. 180? Oh, an acceleration. And this velocity isn't doing anything yet. So, let's see if it moves now. Maybe that, oh, it needs Z velocity. Duh. I mean Z, speed. Let's do 180 speed. I don't know what that should be. I forget the proportions for Z. It's a lot different than Y and X. Okay, now it's finally starting to... The bombs are moving at least, but they're like exploding too soon or way too late, or just the position of the bomb is all weird at the end. And it just keeps exploding and leaving itself on the screen too. Is it doing lots and lots of sound effects too? Like it's going deep, 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 beep, beep. They're not even exploding. They're not even ticking. Oh, it might not even be getting this initial timer either. Because it launches with the lifetime. Oh, here's what's wrong. It's overriding the mood. Okay, so she's launching too many of them. If count bomb foe thrown. Oh, so there's still a bomb on the screen. Oh, you can't have a behavior and a mood explode. That's right. Okay, so the bomb fell. I can't do any of this stuff. You need to get rid of the behavior completely there. I just need to make mood explode smarter. If need be. Okay, there's too much delay now from the bombs. Is that getting said in mood explode actually? Timer begin, timer zero. Yeah. Oh wait, no. When it's never gonna get there because it's launched and launching it, wait. I should debug this and figure it out why it's not setting exactly the right time. So it needs like a really quick timer, and then it needs to like fly in the air. Oh, this should never happen. Okay. I was concerned about this code, but I don't think this ever gets called because this is just if it has a behavior. Oh yeah, bombs, don't even touch that. Okay. Well then, I guess it's just the data. So when the thief boss throws one of these bombs, should have like less delay. That's more simple. And they need to have some kind of velocity. So when I set that to 1 second, oh, probably because it's shorter than its release or something. If it's 2 seconds, it works. I don't This is a hidden boss. Yeah, this is a hidden boss. You're seeing her after she's already been revealed. There, yeah, if I set the delay to 2 seconds, it works like a normal bomb, but if I set it to 1 second, it doesn't. Z velocity. All right, we need Z velocity. I guess man, I can't really think of a better way to do this, but the best way to, I guess, to do this is to, if this is a bomb thrown when it launches the shot here. Oh, see, it schedules the release. That's right. Oh, this is it. So, this is an exploding. Exploding shot. Shot.ai.mood equals K mood explode. Add some Z velocity. shot dot move dot z Excel. Forget how to set this. I think it's a pretty big value though. Ooh. Oh, could you said based on its z speed times. Okay, and then otherwise, regular, this is a regular non-exploding shot. It will schedule a release animation. So basically, it's just a little growing pain of figuring out how to get bombs to explode when they've been launched into the air. So hopefully that gives it some a nice launch into the air. In fact, now we can control it with data. So in thief or yeah, where is it? No, bomb thrown can have we can control how much ZXL comes here. They keep on becoming invisible though. Sometimes. Let's see if now she can throw them with less lifetime and more ZXL for the bombs. Oops, that was weird. Okay, I want the bombs to explode when they hit the ground too. See how far these get thrown now. What's the best way to get these to explode when they hit the ground? I guess if the mood explode, can check in and if it has a... If it has a move component and a ZXL, and it's on the ground. Why do they keep invisible sometimes. Super weird. But anyways, that should be pretty easy just to make it so mood explode. Damn, that's a long function. Now, if it has move component and move speed z, yeah, I use Vim. Yeah, I switched from Xcode to Vim mostly now. I use Xcode to compile. I'm just using this, I'm using it from the command line, Xcode build. See that? And then on Windows, I use Visual Studio. And on Linux, to compile the game, I use just GCC in the command line. So I need to create a CMake script that does it for every platform. That'll be a really nice thing to have. So if it has a Z, and then it has, if the position.pause.z has hit the ground. So we need a ground pause at this point. Oh, you're using VS Code? Really? How are you liking that? I remember when that came out, people were pretty excited about it, but some people said that it was like, it didn't quite have all the features that they needed in an editor or an IDE. I don't remember where there was the IDE part. But anyways, how do you like it? Yeah, totally. Vim on Linux. I like Vim on. Really, really getting to love Vim these past few months. Nice. That's cool. It's good to hear. We have the area. New. The shit. Area. No, it's just blocks, isn't it? Oh no, it is area. Area. Get max tile mag z clamped for e dot position dot pause. All right, so if the position has hit the ground, e.position.pause.z is less than or equal to base z, then explode next time. What the? Oh yeah, you've been using Visual Studio? Yeah, when I was, man, when a long, long time ago in the early 2000s, that's all I used was Visual Studio. And then I took a break from making games for a while. I just wanted to make music. It was a whole phase of my life, just making music. Exploding over and over. And e dot AI dot timer is greater than 0. Explode, but we also need to stop any current movement. So e dot AI.vec equals vec.set. No more vector. E.ai.z velocity Well, the Z Excel is probably expired by the time we hit the ground. So we need to set the vector to null so it doesn't move anymore, I think. And the velocity. If you don't have anything to do with the compass direction, I think that should stop it from moving. So now it should hit the ground and explode right away and stop. Oh, you get the latest enterprise version? Cool. What's Microsoft Imagine? I don't know what that is, or DreamSpark. Oh, that's move velocity. I think there's something else too. E dot move dot excel factor equals 0. So I think that'll help it stop. Yeah, what does Enterprise give you? Oh, she's hurting herself with the bombs. Oh, yeah. So wait, Disruptor, can VS Code compile now? I thought before it was just an editor. Isn't it? Is it actually an IDE now? Yeah. Oh, it's a service where you get their software. That's what Imagine is. Okay, so she's throwing way too many bombs here. Set a timer as well, like timer. Two to 4 seconds or so. And then if timer's less than. Or, oh, no, this is, and there's an easier way to do this. If rand. One in 3 seconds, random. It can compile? Right? Which are like 4 gigs. Yeah, so you have to basically install like Visual Studio to use VS Code, basically. Or how do you get those Visual CPP build tools? Can you get those without Visual Studio? I know, right? Yeah. GCC, Xcode, so easy. You don't need 4 gigs of stuff to build things. Oh, build tools come in their own package now? Really? Has it always been that way? Can you share a link with me? I would really want to know how to install build tools without. Oh, and C Sharp's open source. Wow. Oh, yeah, I heard about that. I heard they're doing that. Was a while ago, right? Isn't that about when they did VS Code? Okay, so she needs to be a little. Oh, nice. That's great. So basically, if you don't need a debug, you can just install this. Oh, there's 2017 now? Can I like wait till 2018 before I start using 2017? I thought this was still like beta. This is so good to know. And wait, if I just typed in. Yeah, okay. I didn't know you could do this. This is so good to know. Wow. This will change everything. Like, especially when I want to go create a VMware, like I create a virtual machine that I just want to compile stuff with, which I do for Windows. I love that. I can just install that on my Windows thing because I don't really test that much. Wait, VS Code also has a debugger? What's an L1T debugger? It's best in class, really? That's wow. I'm impressed. Gosh, it sounds like they've really made some strides with VS Code. I didn't know it was this good. Oh, Leet. Is this Leet? Wow, it does have debugging. Super rad. Oh, lit. Not lead, lit. So wait a minute. You use it on all platforms, Disruptor, right? What's it like to debug using VS Code on a Mac? How does it do that? Does it actually hook up GDB or something or LLDB? What compilers does it use on a Mac? Does it use Xcode build on the back end or LLVM or something? I'm impressed. Oh, yeah. Now, if I could just figure out why they're invisible. Probably has something to do with how it's launched in the start shot method. Oh no, don't worry, man. That's what I'm here for. I'm here to be distracted. Partially. No, I'm really here just to hang out, and like, share what I'm doing, but also like learn what you guys are doing and learn cool new stuff, right? This is how I stay up to date on stuff. I don't want to be behind on stuff. I don't want to miss out on the coolest compilers of today? Jeez. What am I missing out on? What about What about like the new language that Jonathan Blow is writing? Really excited about that too. Chai looks good. Just don't use Notepad plus plus and you're good. Hey, have you tried Notepad minus minus? I really don't know why it's invisible. They just keep on, some of them are invisible. Or minus minus notepad. Sweet, man. Nice. What's Prim's algorithm again? Notepad minus minus is a thing. I'm really talking. You should go Google. You should Google notepad minus minus right now. So I kind of want her to get into this mood where she stops. Yeah, so if she starts throwing bombs, I want her to stop there for a second. So actually, she at the end of this, she should go into mode. Like mode five or something, mode two maybe actually. It's fine. Yeah, I don't know. Mode 20. Doesn't give the results. Oh. Oh. Why not? Dude, I got it right here. Is it on SourceForge? Wait, somebody else made Notepad minus minus as well? Oh my God, somebody else made a Notepad minus minus. Is this in the meantime that you created Notepad minus minus? Was 2 years ago. I don't know. Yours has less features. That's for sure. That's the whole point. Oh, it's a greedy algorithm for minimum spanning tree. Oh, cool. Nice, right on. So this will allow her to throw bombs in either one of these modes. That's just mode ones. So we could use mode two for that. Came out on the same day. What? The internet was fast on that one. They're like, whoa. Boogie just released the best thing ever. Let's release something just like it. So just need to use a timer here. Or actually just delay. Yeah, you just delay 2, 3. And oh, she needs to set a direction none. So she stops moving. Oh, also sets a path none. So if rand is less than 0.5, so she's got a 50% chance to do this if she's already in the mode. Hopefully this means so she just stops for a minute, starts throwing some bombs, and then once she's tired of it, then she goes into back into the mode where she's chasing you. Oh, and she can't be hurt by her own bombs. Why is that happening? Oh yeah, she just not have any kind of bomb. No damage from bombs. Oh, and every kind of resistance, that's right. Like, oh, Metatron. Yeah, fire resist, ice resist, all those resistances. It's gonna be a hard boss fight, it should be. This is cool, I like it. Giving it a velocity when it lands. I'm really curious why it's not. The bombs are, they hit the ground, but then they slide for a minute. And really, I don't know why they're sliding. I guess maybe their decel duration. Yeah. In this background? Or the game's background? There's a bird? Did you guys see a bird? Was there a bird at the window? That would have been sweet. Oh yeah, there's definitely some chirping. Yeah, there's lots of birds out there, tiny little birds. We live in basically in like near a bunch of trees that have all this is birds love it around here. Crazy good for birds. Should be the bomb foe throne. Yeah, this is it. So what do we got here? It's got a compass direction. I thought you were supposed to have vector movement. Oh, it doesn't matter. I guess we just have to stop the compass direction. And any input. E.ai.dir equals E.move.compassdir equals kdir none. I guess I should have done that from the beginning. It's like the most basic part of movement. Right? Yeah, out here in the Bay Area, Oakland. I like Oakland. It's pretty cool. We used to live in San Diego, and there's like, you look up at the hills, and there's no trees on any of the hills down in any of Southern California, basically. There's no trees. But you come up a little bit further north, like the Bay Area and stuff, you finally have trees on the hills. And I love it because it reminds me of home in Oregon. There we go. Now it's just hitting the ground, sticking there, and exploding. All right, now we've seen some custom art for these kind of bombs. Yeah, you got tons of trees and mountains in Washington. Oh my God, you got some crazy cool mountains in Washington. Yeah, I love it. I love climbing mountains. This is my one of my favorite hobbies. Like just hiking, hiking up mountains, maybe doing a little bit of bouldering at the top or along the way. Sometimes rock climbing too. If there's some ropes. I don't really own any ropes, but I do own rock climbing shoes, finally. Bomb, ba bomb, bomb. Bomb, foe. Oh yeah, you visited here a while ago. Oh, you teach mountain climbing? Really? That's interesting. For real? Like what kind of tell me all about it, man. You know what? I think I just want to try it just scale down at first. So bomb foe throne is just render scale maybe 0.5. Yeah, that's cool. Oh, except I think they're not quite the right scale at first, are they? Let's see, slow down time. Yeah, okay. That scale, and then this is just idle foe 0. Or bomb foe 0. And no tick. There's really no tick to these. Yeah, you can slow down time. I got some debug keys that really help debugging the game. And one of them is slowing down time. Very important. You can slow down or speed up time. Like this, if I want to skip past this, I just speed up time. See that? And I slow back down to normal time. It's crazy when she throws the bombs because you don't have any idea where she's at. Because she doesn't have any footprints. Don't be in this mood forever. Why is she throwing them randomly too? Oh, I guess because she's got to face the right way. Attack thief boss has to throw her face when she wants to throw a bomb. She needs to set the direction towards the target. Maybe even face target. Here we go. If she's already thrown a bomb. And if Rand in 1 second, maybe? So let me get rid of the Rand there. I'm trying to get her to stay in the mode where she's throwing bombs for a second, but then go back into chasing you. Yeah, she's just stuck in bomb A the whole time. Is she getting the right? She's got mode two. Oh, it might be the. Oh, it might be she gets the mode bomb B, but then it goes straight back into mode bomb A. Oh, okay, I got it. We just set a maximum timer. So like a timer of like she could be in this mode for up to 6 to 9 seconds or so or something like that. And then after that, she can't. If we're in mode two and if timer is greater than zero, once timer becomes zero or less, she can't keep throwing bombs until she gets back into mode zero, and that happens here. Okay, let's hope that works. All right, so this is coming along though. I'm really liking how she can throw bombs, but I hope this really works with her whole invisible thing. I think it does because it's really interesting to see somebody throwing bombs where you don't know where the source quite is. Oh, bomb A resets the timer. Okay, so we need to succeed. If timer is less than zero, still not working. What did I do wrong? Man, I don't know what's going on here. This is confusing me. So maybe if I go to the AI system, I can log out what the timer is. That'll help. Oh, it already has this built in. Oh, it does. Why is your timer not ticking down? Her timer ain't working. Not at all. I might need to debug here in a second. Let's get Xcode open. Guess we need to do this for the delay timer and the timer. I guess I could do a mode counter so she only throws like up to three bombs at once. Why is this not working? I don't know. I need to take a break from this right now. Kind of weary standing on my legs, I guess, or something. Anyways, well, it's been a pretty productive stream, though. This hidden boss is pretty cool. I'm really loving how she's not only is she the hidden boss, like you have to like really, you know, try to even fight her, but she's also really hidden. She actually is invisible, which makes for a really interesting boss fight. In fact, if I could just get her to not bomb the whole time. Here, I'll just make it so she can't even throw a bomb at all. Or wait, I could just go if ran 3 or something. I don't know. I didn't know I wanted to watch this, but I do. Cool. Okay, I'm gonna try this one last time before I go for today. So she really just needs like a good running animation so when you hit her, she can kind of glitch a little bit better. And a good death animation. And yeah, that's a lot better when she's at least chasing you. Oh, she's trying to follow her path and she can't. Oh, she doesn't have pathfind. Move pathfind. Does Keel have that problem too? Oh, no, he has pathfind and boundary. Terrains. He needs all these. She needs all these. And footprints. There, now she won't get stuck anymore. Oh, sweet. Now she can pathfind. Oh, this is a lot better. Still no bombs. Oh yes, she finally! She threw a bomb and then decided to stop throwing bombs. Good enough for now. Yeah, this is gonna be a really interesting boss fight. I love how she's just invisible. Don't know where she's at until, like, sometimes you don't pay attention to the feet moving on the ground. Yeah, I think she should maybe have a little bit of transparency. Oops. Something just to give it so you know where to aim sometimes. Like every once in a while she should have like a little bit of transparency so you can see her. Would really help this be a little bit less frantic. It's really great though. I love this feeling of like fighting somebody and completely invisible. She just needs to be a little bit more opaque sometimes. And I don't think she's gonna spawn these like Keel does. Just because I copied Keel's AI at first. But anyways, this is going to be turn out to be a pretty cool boss fight. Let's just cheat and kill her. Watch that. Yep, there you go. Boss fight on the overworld where you get the flask. Oh, she didn't give me the flask? I don't know, something went wrong there. But anyways, this could be a cool fight. She should stay invisible. Oh yeah, exactly. So like I'm thinking when you hurt her, like you hit her, or she becomes does her melee or whatever, she like she glitches in and out somehow. I'm gonna try and work on the graphics there. But yeah. Alright, cool guys. Well, I'll check y'all next time. All have a great night. Thanks for watching and yeah, see you next time. Whoa, it's a long stream.